Okay, Michael, so I pulled up this web page. We will provide a link to it on our own web pages, and you'll notice there's a really nice copy right here, and this is all free to use, so I'm not doing anything wrong here. They're going to use independent components analysis as a way of recovering original sounds. So here you see that I've clicked onto a police car, somebody talking in a commercial, and let's say this dude here. And what it's going to do is it's going to generate sounds for each of these three sources that are all independently generated, and it's going to mix them. So if I click on these icons here, of these microphones, see, these look just like what I drew before, you'll be able to hear each of their sounds combined together. So I'm going to put my microphone very close to it so you can hear it.
Riippumattomien komponenttien analyysi seuloo suurista tietomääristä automaattisesti esiin käyttäjän kannalta olevan.
And here's another one of the microphones.
The guardians of the electronic stock market NASDAQ have been burned by past ethics questions.
Okay, so Michael, could you hear that?
Yes.
Okay, so what I did is I played two of the mixed sounds together, and to the untrained ear, they sound very much alike. But I think the most important thing is all three of these sounds are over on top of one another. And as human beings, we actually do a pretty good job of being able to focus on one of them because, I don't know, we're designed to do that. But machines have historically had a terrible time of doing this. And independent components analysis was the first sort of generic algorithm that was able to solve this. So we're going to use ICA now to separate the sound sources. And as you see, we get these little gramophone things. And I'm going to play each one of these and see if they did a good job of separating us into the original sources.
Riippumattomien komponenttien analyysi seuloo suurista tietomääristä automaattisesti esiin käyttäjän kannalta oleellista.
The guardians of the electronic stock market NASDAQ, who have been burned by past ethics questions, are moving.
Okay, so wasn't that kind of cool, Michael? I mean, we took these completely mixed up sounds and we were able to recover the original by using independent components analysis.
That's fascinating. I don't still understand what it's doing, but it's pretty neat that it could do that because it sounded pretty mixed up to me.
Well, it was. It was, in fact, each one of these three sources that we eventually heard were, in fact, arbitrarily, linearly combined into each of these separate microphones. And there's really sort of no way in which you'd be able to recover the original sounds because there's no reason for you to be able to do that. But people do it all the time. And now with something like independent components analysis, you can also do it. And the reason it works with independent components analysis, and that fundamental assumption that it's making, is that whatever's generating in these cases these sounds, the sources, are statistically independent of one another, which happens to be true in that case, and they're combined together in a way that is a linear combination. Now, there's a lot of details here, and again, when you read the material, you'll see exactly how independent components analysis works, but intuitively, all it's doing is taking this particular model and by using mutual information directly to find things that are independent of one another while not losing any information from the observables, it's able to reconstruct these sounds. And it's able to do this incredibly quickly and incredibly well under a large number of conditions.